Okay, we're back with Bro Latef, the Naya Bingi warrior, Ethiopian World Federation representative, and the performer, writes his own lyrics and performs the drums, the bass drums with other brethren. And we're speaking with Bro Latef live in the flesh here in Crawley on WTED Television. Bro Latef.
Yeah.
We have this beautiful CD package in our hands right now.
Yeah.
Tell us how you got it started and what's on there. And well, who are the musicians who have helped you to produce
well,
this?
Well, this record there, as a member of EWF and playing Naya Bingi with the Federation, and as members travel there and there and forth and, you know, running away, I would say sometimes I organize a Naya Bingi session.
Right.
And then I get brothers together so we can play Naya Bingi music. And then sometime when I had a brother by my home, he asked me, Latef, what you can play for me to hear? I said, well, brother, I have nothing I can play for you to hear, you know. Because every time I do an effort to get something record, I never get an answer for that. So he said, but you can do something, you know, Latef. I said, yeah. He said, yeah, I have that instrument and we can do that. So I said, okay, let's go. And we did it.
What instrument was that?
He had a
studio.
Yeah, a moving studio.
Okay.
And we do that, and then from there, I write the songs, and they do the concept musically, Naya Bingi music, drum and voice. And then by this, I get this there, this album, this track there. So it has me on the voice, on the ears, and the life of the people.
Right.
Because it is with them, it is with us. So you can hear, when you come by my home, you can hear what I sing.
Right.
And then when I give you, you can carry with me wherever you go.
That's right.
So that is evangelizing the life of Rastafari. And I think it is very important for me to be there. As for a long time, Rastafari, I have to be doing my work.
So what has been the response like internationally to your work, financially?
As I did this, I say I did it for the people.
Yeah.
I didn't do it so I can look to get a big financial bigs of that. I did it for the voice to be heard.
Yeah, so you can get good positive feedback from people.
I have get very, very good I will say that good
responses
for that work I have done there. And then as I said, I did it for the people, and then I didn't look for money from it, but I know money can come from it.
Okay.
You see, but it was not the objective. The objective is for let the voices be heard, and let my voice be heard of the struggle. So, this I very appreciate how far it is today, because on the internet, it says on the internet, and then I give to people as I walk every time.
So, what is your favorite track on the album?
Well, if I had to say the favorite track on the album, is the last track. It says, I will sing of your mercy and your judgment. I will sing of your mercy and your judgment. Unto you, O Jah, I will sing. I want to always put myself as a servant of the Lord. So I have to praise Him for everything. So by that, I will keep myself on the right track.
Okay, Bro Latef, you've gone on a number of travels, you know, on the continent, in Europe. Tell us a little bit about your travels, especially on the continent. Or what's your reaction to what your experiences over there?
You see, it's true, I have traveled a few times because I've been traveling from since 1982. And the first time I went to Martinique, my brother told me, Latef, I want to tell you something, and what I tell you, you must never forget that, and you will see it. anywhere you go, you must find and you will find somebody to put you right on the right track. I never had a failure anywhere I travel. And anywhere I did go, Rastafari, he placed someone to take me and comfort me. And I give thanks for that because I've been living like this. And I traveled to Martinique and Guadeloupe. In Martinique, I organized with the brothers, a branch of the EWF in Guadeloupe. I worked with the brothers EWF. They had another family jar business in Guadeloupe. I worked with them. And then from there, I traveled to France, then to London. I met the brothers of London on the movement of EWF, had meetings with them. The first time in St. Agnes Place, and then in other places around Big Stones and so. And then I traveled to Africa, and so I went to Senegal first time with an organization we say Africa en Journée. So we.
What does that mean for those of us that can't speak French or Patois? Africa en Journée.
Africa en Journée is. African genre. Africa and genre is Africa is in a state where we what it has done to Africa and the poverty that is left there by in the people among the people. So it's and you see Africa and genre because we look for some funds to develop and we ask for pièce jaune.
So what is jaune?
The pièce jaune is the coins of the euro zone.
Okay.
We have the 10 cents and the 20 and the 50. So we ask for those things, we call it pièce jaune, so say Africa and jaune. Mm. And we do that, we help the handicapped physique, you know, those that cannot walk and, you know. And we brought up, I take with me when I was going to Africa, to Senegal, with organizations, some bakeries and different things for the handicaps and so. And we organized two concerts. We had a concert in Blessengo Cultural Center. There is a big cultural center. And we did that for the benefit of the handicaps.
Right.
So all the benefit of the show, you know, is for the handicaps people. We did that and it was very, very exciting and it was very big because there are a lot of people. And a few weeks after, a brother called and said, you want to have a show? And then we say, okay, we organize it, but it's Africa genre, and we're doing that for the handicaps. And we had another show in Indigo Cafe restaurant. It's a big in Dakar itself. Mm. And it was very, very nice, and people, a lot of people, just very strong. And this goes like that, and then we had interviews on the radio, on the television, and to meet organization, different organization. And we travel to Gore where we have the door for the slave trades and so, play there,
yeah.
And so, and then when we came back, we stayed going back to in Dakar, stayed a month in Dakar, and then we traveled back to Paris. And in Paris, I performed in Naya Bingi music, different places in Paris, and you know, letting the voice of the people be heard.
Right.
In songs and drum power, Rastafari.
So Rastafari, not everyone, believe it or not, in 2011 knows what Rastafari means. The sea man, your dreadlocks beard, you know, can you explain to the people what it is being a Rastafarian? Why dreadlocks? Why ganja? Why reggae? Why is Imperial Majesty? Why we say and do these things?
Well, it's a big letter Y.
Yeah.
You know, it's a big letter Y. Simple reason is because we lose all our faith. We lose what we have. So we say Y. Why put yourself in question?